Hey, if you're planning to become a blockchain developer, then this video is for you. Let's get started. The first step is understanding what a blockchain is. You need to understand the fundamental concepts of why we need blockchain in the first place and how the whole system works. Only then you'll be able to better understand while programming it. It's more like understanding a computer's memory so that you can become a good programmer. Next, you need to choose which blockchain you really want to work on. I would suggest to start understanding the ecosystem one by one instead of trying to learn about multiple blockchains at the same time. You can start with Bitcoin at first, understand how it works, and then move on to Ethereum. Ethereum has an advantage of writing smart contracts. This is where you see a lot of devs very much concentrated because of smart contract development. Learn any of one blockchain completely. For example, with Ethereum, you have the Ethereum virtual machine. You need to understand every part of it. Learn it thoroughly. Learn as much as information as you could find, because this will really help you stand out. Next, you need to learn to program it. So let me break it down here. When I say a blockchain developer, there are two kinds of blockchain developers. One is the core and the other is smart contract developers. The core engineers or developers, they work on creating a blockchain itself. For example, Satoshi Nakamoto was a core engineer. He actually wrote down the code and developed the blockchain itself, actually coding the blockchain. The next type is a smart contract developer. That's one part of blockchain development. You need to understand what a smart contract is in order to better understand this video. I would also suggest to check out a video on smart contracts. It's basically an agreement written in code. You can literally code any agreement without a need for a central authority. That's what smart contract is in simple words. So I told you about two of the blockchain engineers, the core and the smart contract developers. So the core is mostly written in C++ or Rust. Rust is a very interesting language. You can also write smart contracts with it. You can write the core also with it. For the purpose of this video, let's focus on the smart contract development alone. So now that you have learned what a blockchain is and learned completely about one blockchain ecosystem, and now you go on to learn how to write programs in that blockchain. For Ethereum, we have Solidity, with which you can write smart contracts. As of today, Solidity is very widely popular, and because a lot of libraries are written on it, it is gaining traction, and I do see Solidity to stay here for long. Yule is a very popular assembly language for Solidity, and most of the time some core functions will be written using Yule or assembly. Yule is not that hard to learn. You can just learn it in a week or so if you just practice well. One more thing. You can completely program with Yule, but most of the times developers use Solidity for the ease of use and use the code from Yule in specific functions for specific purposes. You need to able to develop, write the code, and deploy it to the blockchain. Remember, certain development frameworks are particularly very useful for this. If you're good with JavaScript, then you can choose Hardhat. If you're good with Solidity itself, you can use the framework Foundry. So with Foundry, there's a bit of advantage because you learn Solidity and you also write your tests with Solidity. So it makes it quite easy. I learned Foundry. There's also one more advantage of Foundry. You can write fast testing with it. Let me get back to testing at the end of the video. But just remember, Foundry has an advantage. So now we learn blockchain. Learned a programming language with it, and then we went on to framework. So here we develop on the IDE and also deploy it and are able to write tests with it. This pretty much is very basic. You mandatorily need to know to become a blockchain developer or a smart contract developer. It's non-negotiable. You need to be really good at these things. Next, we need users, and users need to interact with the blockchain. That's why we have a front end. You need a library to connect them. That's where Web3.js, Ether.js, Web3.py. That's a Python library. These three libraries help you connect the backend to the front end. It's very much easy to learn. You only need one project to, you know, completely understand it. The documentations are very clear, and don't just think, oh, that's all this front end stuff. I don't need to learn. No, please. Just go ahead and learn at least one of these libraries. And the next comes file storage. For a decentralized system, that it also needs a decentralized storage. This comes with IPFS or Arweave or Filecoin. You can choose it. The easiest one is IPFS, although it has some trade-offs. But knowing to use IPFS is really important. You need to know how to access the decentralized storage, particularly if you are using any kind of, if you are into any of the projects related to NFTs, then you wouldn't want a decentralized NFT to be stored somewhere in a centralized server. Next, oracles. Oracles are truth-telling machines. Let's say we have a blockchain that has no interaction, or it doesn't know anything whatever is happening in the real world. You need some kind of an oracle or a truth-telling machine to guide this blockchain. Hey, listen, this is what is happening. For example, in real time, you might need to know that it's raining in a particular area. So how would this blockchain know that the temperature has fallen in this particular area? You need some kind of system that actually monitors it and tells it to the blockchain. But again, it cannot be a single centralized system. So oracles actually have multiple nodes that work on these data sets, consolidates it. It has its own consensus and comes together and tells it to the blockchain. I will definitely make a video on what oracles are with much more details. But yeah, oracles is a huge part of Web3 or blockchain development. You absolutely need to know how to use these oracles. What the price of USD today is, or what the exchange between USD and INR today is. You need to know that data, and you would use it in your contracts. You would better understand oracles of how important they are once you start programming. We have some amazing oracles like Chainlink, and Uniswap has become so popular for oracles. Okay, we have written all of our smart contract programming. So how do we deploy it? We need to download a whole blockchain node to our computer and get started with deploying it. But that would require an incredibly high amount of data and time too. This is where node providers come in. There are node providers like Alchemy, Infura, and QuickNode. Yeah, I use Alchemy most of the time. So with these nodes, you don't need to actually download the complete, example, Ethereum node in order to deploy your contract. You can simply have a subscription or the API key with these node providers, who would then provide the node as a service to you. The process is incredibly simple, very simple, as like you just go ahead, create an app, get an API key from them, go ahead and use it. I wouldn't call it particularly as a skill set that you should develop, but these are things that you would use in everyday life. So this is all done. This is all part of smart contract development. Now comes testing. So you have unit tests, first fuzz and invariant tests, static analysis, formal verification, etc. For this, there are a lot of tools which people use. But if you're trying to become a developer, I would suggest that you need to know to develop a contract and also at the very minimum, write unit tests for it. Remember that once a contract is deployed, it's incredibly hard to change it. Of course, you have upgradable contracts, but that has a lot of trade-offs. So you need to perform a high amount of tests before you deploy it to the blockchain, especially when you're dealing with something like DeFi, where you have a lot of people's money that goes into stake. For testing, especially unit and fuzz testing, you have Foundry and also Echidna. For static analysis, there's Slither and Adrian. For formal verification, we have Solidity SMT Checker and Manticore. However, this is quite like a second level of a smart contract developer. First, you need to know and understand the basics of smart contract development to go ahead, test it and deploy it at the very least to a testnet. You also need to know to write unit tests for your contracts. Then you have the next step of career path where you can become a security researcher or an auditor. This mostly comes to checking the smart contract code for bugs. Let's first focus on becoming a really good smart contract developer and land some incredible experiences. To get started, basically just learn EVM, Solidity, YOL, and Foundry. That's my preference that I suggest to you. After that, go ahead and learn Rust if possible, because from what I learned, you can also land a Web2 job or a Web3 job. You can write smart contracts with it. You can also core engineer it to create your own blockchain or layer 2, etc. Good luck. And if you do become a blockchain developer, please come back to this video and let me know how your process went and what your tech stack right now is. Bye.